Looking forward to seeing this on Speedway Video.
Speedway Video.
Speedway Video.
Speedway Video. He's up there doing his job.
Speedway Video does a great job.
I learn something new every time I watch.
I'm even faster when you watch it on Speedway Video.
Go to patreon.com/speedwayvideo now.
Setting fast time today, it's the Breathe Easy Medical Supply number 00 for Anthony Cataldi. To his inside, Macross Electric number 56. Let's hear it for Brandon Morris. Now, ladies and gentlemen, your front row for the Fall Brawl Sportsman 200 on the outside, and car number 14 out of Lakeland, it's going to be Adam Briggs. And starting on the bowl tonight, out of Davie, Florida, the number 16 right foot down motorsports machine for Tim Sozio.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's have a big round of applause for your field of sportsmen here tonight. Are you guys ready for 200 laps of the Fall Brawl? You guys can do better than that. Are you guys ready for some great sportsman racing? That's what we like to hear.
All right, here we go. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, drivers, start.
Thank you.
once the crews are permitted to touch the cars.
We're down here with Stage 1 winner for the Fall Brawl 200, Anthony Cataldi. Anthony, off to a pretty solid start, fast qualifier, and then you just pick up $3,000 more here to win Stage 1.
Yeah, starting fourth there, I mean, they had a pretty good shot to stay up the front, and I think it's pretty sporty, so I just kind of bided my time there, and then the two leaders just kind of got together, so I capitalized on that, and then was able to just get them on the restart on the outside, go around, and this thing's a hot rod.
Got a long way still to go. We're going to have a pill draw to determine where you start for race number two, so we don't know where you're going to start just yet, but odds are it's not going to be where you're at right now.
No, I would say not, but I mean, that's part of this deal, that we knew that getting in there was going to be an invert, so we're just going to take the invert for what it is and just take care of our car and get there at the end.
All right, Anthony Cataldi leading the way right now. He wins stage one.
Tim Sozio looking pretty strong at the beginning of this thing, led some laps and we're able to fight back to second, so we got two more races coming up. What's the outlook for the rest of the night?
Yeah, we're going to try and tighten this thing up a little bit. I actually just couldn't get in the throttle at all, but let's see what happens. Going to try and just be there at the end.
Looks like it's getting kind of slick out there, especially when the tires start to heat up. And you got to use the same tires for the rest of the race. Are you going to move them around, or do you like where they're at?
I think we're going to do something. I don't know yet. But, yeah, it's definitely slick out there. We, you know, got to watch getting on the throttle.
What's it going to take? I know the double zero is fast right now. What's it going to take to get by him in the next race?
I don't know. He's fast, so we'll see.
All right, Tim Sozio brings home second in segment number one. He'll go to work and get ready for the next race.
75 laps, man, are pretty exhausting, but got a pretty sporty car. Your car looked pretty good on the outside of those restarts, but the double zero, man, he's pretty quick.
Yeah, this is the first time this car's been a long run like this. We were in Auburn 2 weeks ago, doing a few laps, so we went in with you in a long run, so we're going to work on it here and see what we got.
So, leading the race and then under caution, some contact there with the 56. Didn't get to see it, but what happened there from your point of view?
Not sure. Really don't know.
All right, so we'll see what Adam Briggs has for stage number two. He finishes third here in his first stage.
Devin, you got the crew hard at work here, trying to get this thing tighten up for the next segment, but man, you made a lot of passes out there. You start kind of mid-pack, were able to race your way up to fourth. What's it been like out there?
Man, I wish it was 200 laps straight. I think the longer we ran, the better we got, so really, you know, I think during that short run, we weren't as good as, I think, at least the double zero, maybe the 16, I don't know, but I think the cars continue to get to us as these tires get worn out. Good thing I got to bring the right rear I'm going to put on the next 50 and let drive by them at the end.
Well, we'll see how that's going to go. Devin McLeod with a solid run. Keep your eye on the 23 car. He's still in the running for the overall. And we tried to get what happened from Adam Briggs. I think Austin's going to go find Brandon Morris to see if we can find out more about the contact that happened after the yellow flag. Crew's still hard at work down here getting his cars ready.
Down here with Brandon Morris in the 56. Up front, earlier on in this thing, caution comes out for something in the back of the field. Next thing I know, you're all crossed up.
We were still up at racing. We didn't even know the caution was out yet, but it's hard racing, a little bit of contact. Yes, it's unnecessary on probably both of our parts, but it is what it is. Starting to start running together on the tire, so it's got about 185 laps right now, so it ain't concerned.
All right, there you go, Brandon Morris. Definitely disappointed and rightfully so. Definitely had a fast car today. Looks like his day is going to be done.
All right, we just got our lineup for race number two. It's an eight-car invert. So Anthony Cataldi will have to come from eighth on the grid. Matthew Green is going to lead us to the grid. Stage two.
Support Speedway Video. Go to patreon.com/speedwayvideo now.